Hello YouTube, this is Thomas, seeing as I don't really use a specific alias on the internet at the time. This is for you guys that love the Cyborg R.A.T. 9. I got mine here and I had a really bad problem with it, that every time it would scroll up, it was also at the same time scroll down and vice versa, which is kind of annoying. So I thought it might be a driver problem. I thought it might be the computer. I taken it to multiple computers, even tried different mouses, but only with this mouse, the Cyborg R.A.T. 9 from Madcat, I was having this issue. So I decided to take it apart and see what the problem was, and lo and behold, seeing as this thing is overused so much, because I game nearly, well, every waking moment that I'm not doing something important like eating, personal hygiene, going to work or whatever, or sleeping, I'm basically sitting behind the computer with my hand on this thing. So there was a little bit of dirt that came into it, into the sensor for the scroll wheel, which was the main problem here. And I'm going to show you guys how what I did to take it apart safely without breaking it, and how to get it clean easily. At the same time, it'll allow me to do some badly needed cleaning on the mouse surface itself, because the buttons are dirty, the roller is dirty itself, so taking off the covers is a really good time to do this sort of thing. So I'm going to show you that right now. Okay, so here's my Cyborg R.A.T. 9. There's only one thing, or actually two things you really need to do this, is a little Phillips head screwdriver, really small. This one is about, well, a couple of millimeters thick. I think about 3 millimeters or something thick. I don't want to go any bigger because you won't be able to fit it in the holes. Now there are three screws in this thing. Over here, hidden behind the plate here, and right here in front of the bolt that operates the little thumb rest. So first, the second tool is the little included Allen key itself. So what you do, of course, I gotta take the power out of this thing first. So there we go, that's the power. Let's leave that there. So you take off the little pinky rest. I use this type. Most people have been known to say that this pinky rest isn't the most comfortable one, but I like it because it keeps my fingers off of the surface of the table, because I hate having it touch. Removing the backrest. Now you don't really need to take this off, the palm rest. I just like to because it gives me a firm grip with this out of the way when I'm working on it. So there's the tool. Now there's one right here. It's just, you have to use a little bit of pressure because they're kind of tight in the plastic. And it comes out. Come on, boy. And there we go. And there's one screw. Now the one in the center is also a long one. And now the last one, that's right there beside the pinky rest. Now there's one thing I do want to note straight away now. If you look at the screws, don't know if you can see it clearly, but the final one that I removed near the button is a lot shorter than the rest. You actually need to remember that, because I've noticed that if I tried to put the longer one in, it would push this side of the button up, which causes all sort of clicking problems. So you really need to keep that in mind. The shorter screw goes here near the button, near this button here, so you don't get confused or get any problems with clicking afterward. Now that's done. It's really easy to pick up the whole back side of it. What you want to do is gently push it that way to the rear while it's lifted up, because there are two retainers in front of it. There we go. It goes a little bit rough, but that's basically your mouse disassembled. Now, I already cleaned this myself, But there was a lot of dust and hairs and shit right around this sensor here, which is for the scroll wheel right next to the right mouse button. So what you just want to do, mark one breath. Best solution there is, just hold it like this, blow in it, and at the same time while you're blowing close to your mouth, be sure not to use any saliva with it or else you're gonna fuck it up, is just scroll a little bit while you're blowing into it, and that gets all the junk out of the sensor real quick, real easy too. And yeah, that's just a reverse action of reassembling. So I'll do that in a sec to show you the whole thing. Ah, don't you just love interruptions? Anyways, yeah, cleaning done. Cleaned up as best I could, but I'll be more detailed with it later. Let's put it together. Now, as you might see that here on the front, don't know if you can see the detail on here, but there's actually some holes in the front that have to slot in to the front of the mouse right here. So what you want to do is keep it at an angle, just press it in, make sure that this long edge doesn't end up behind this wire that goes through here. Actually needs to be closest to the wall with the wire sticking to the circuit board, or else you're gonna break the wire off. But just stick the front end first, then you kinda have to force it. I don't know if they got it in smooth, but you kinda have to force this thing in by hooking in the front and then kind of breaking it in. Come on, there we go, those are in. Press the back in and the front. Go. Ah, there it is. Snaps into place. So that's that done. Now I just have to put the screws back in. And that should be that. You do want to be careful. As I'm pressing on this, it'll actually try to push the whole thing out again, so make sure you got a good grip on it with your thumb and your finger until at least the initial screw is in. Now the other long screw. He said screw. Now keep in mind that short one needs to go underneath the little mode selector. So that drops in like so. Oh, and by the way, if you're wondering how, what I'm using to make my screw stick to my screwdriver, just find a magnet, like a magnesium one that comes in a hard drive, or any old magnet will do, even your kitchen magnet will do, and just rub the iron, the exposed metal of your screwdriver against it. Just put it on, stroke it, take it off, put it on, stroke it, take it off. Do it about 3 times, 4 times, depending on your magnet strength, and some of the magnetic forces will be trapped inside your screwdriver, which allows you to, well, let your screws stick and put them in that way. No need to use those fancy little grippers in order to put a screw in a hole like this. Okay, final things in. Battery. Palm rest. Allen key I still need. Put the side in. The pinky rest. Yep. Like so. Ah, I'm right-handed, not left-handed. And that is your Cyborg R.A.T. 9 done and cleaned. If you like this video, please, well, like it, favorite, share it to other people who use this kind of mouse and have the same kind of problem. I'm just testing here on my screen, which you can't see to be honest, but it is working perfectly again after I cleaned all the dirt out. So, that's pretty much it, guys.